and it may indicate a mini stroke. And this tiny sound cues a few neurons in your brain, and then you forget things. And a mini stroke leads to a severe stroke. And in that situation, you have lost your priceless memories and the ability to move, even like this. And this tragedy happens to 15 million people every year. So most of you must be thinking now, is there a cure for this disease? Unfortunately, we don't have a medication to protect our neurons from dying. But the scientist has achieved a milestone in understanding how neurons die. A protein called GNK has been identified as a killer. So people try to eliminate this killer to save our neurons. This strategy works, but it causes severe side effects because this killer has another job that maintains normal brain functions. So now you see the dilemma. If we keep GNK, it causes brain damage. But if we remove GNK, it causes brain dysfunction. So how do we solve this problem? So I start to think, how GNK becomes a bad killer from a good worker? There must be something that urges GNK to change. So after several rounds of screening experiments, I indeed identified a suspect called NEEP, a trigger protein. It talks to GNK by the protein-protein interaction, and when stroke occurs, this trigger protein pushes a special button on GNK to make it become a killer. Even more exciting, I found this button is never used in healthy neurons. That means this button can be used as a drug target to stop the killer while bypassing the good functions of GNK. So I went a step further and invented a compound to prevent this trigger protein from touching the button. This compound not only prevents stroke-induced brain damage and the behavior deficits in animals, but also significantly reduces side effects that haven't been solved by any other ways. Maybe in the near future, with this medication, just one pill, we can really save our brains and all good memories. Thank you.